And now we're going to read into burnout. Anybody know what burnout is? We're going to go through the definitions. Okay, emotional exhaustion, overextended and exhausted by work. Depersonalization, so you get a negative cynical attitude. You might treat your patients as objects more if you get into this level of burnout. And sense of low personal accomplishment, feelings of incompetence, inefficiency, and inadequacy. These are the three realms that we study burnout in people, and we do that by giving them a burnout inventory that was popularized by Maslach. And this MBI is what we call it when we're doing work with psych folks or social workers. And they give you one of these tests. I did that to D3 and 4 class 2 years ago as part of the Mermelstein. And they scored exactly like medical students, pharmacy students, and everyone else. 30% of people meet criteria for burnout in one or two of these categories if you survey you guys at any given time. That seems to be fairly consistent through all these health professional degrees. Okay, so students get burnout. Okay? Causes of burnout: overwork, sleep deprivation, low control, and high responsibility. Inadequate support, lack of self-awareness, and imbalance between personal and professional life. And when we study people with burnout, one of the most important categories is this one: the imbalance between personal and professional life. Okay? Consequences of it. For work, is you've got lower empathy. This has been studied. This is not me making this up. We get higher medical errors, we get people quitting practice, and they have poor personal relationships. All this stuff carries over at home, and you'll see increased rates of substance abuse. Auto accidents, probably from distraction, stress-related health problems, which we talked about before, and marital and familial stress.